Hey guys, it's JT Tran, USA's number one Asian dating coach. And I know I always say it, but today I really do have a very special guest. We are always talking about how to meet women, how to go on dates with them. But what about when you're ready for a relationship? Well, today I brought Jamie Faye, a relationship expert and relationship coach, to talk to you exactly that. How to be in a relationship, keep the spark alive, and how to maintain a long distance relationship. But first, before we get into that, Jamie, tell our audience a little bit about yourself.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for having me, JT. I'm Jamie Faye, like JT said, and I am a relationship coach, and I work with individuals and couples all over the world. I'm international. And how I got into this? I've been coaching for a while now, a little more than 10 years, in people's relationships professionally, romantically, and what else?
Just where are you based?
I'm based out of Tel Aviv, but I work online with about a little more than half of my clients. So wherever right. You are, I am.
You work with groups, you work with couples, so she is a relationship expert. Now, because you are a relationship expert, one of the most common topics I get asked is like, hey JT, I met this girl, you know, I met her at a bar, club, online dating, OkCupid, whatever, and things start to happen, there's some romance, but maybe she lives a couple hours outside the city, or even further, like I myself have dated girls that were in like New York, London, Florida, Vegas, Australia, and I'm trying to maintain it, and it's tough, isn't it?
Yeah, it totally is. I also was in a long-term relationship, once from New York to Tel Aviv for almost 9 months. So it was really far, but we made it work. So you're asking me how to make that work.
Yeah, what are some really good tips that the guys can use where like they've met someone and maybe they had a whirlwind romance and they want to keep it alive, but they're separated by distance?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's really important to know that person's time zone and to know their schedule and ask them. Tell them, you know, I'd love to keep talking with you without putting too much pressure on them, right? Because you don't know if there's a kind of vacation-y fling, which is what I thought I kind of had and it turned into love and a long-term relationship, is being really mindful about not putting too much pressure on them, but also showing them that you want to continue this relationship, whatever you want to call it. And then find out, you know, when would be a good time to chat with you a couple days from now? Wednesday. Is Wednesday a good day for you? Just like you would with when you're asking for a date. And see, okay, is before work good for you? Is like, be you know, mindful of their schedule and respectful and ask them and show them and then see how they react. And it may take some time to build up trust. For them, they might be surprised. Wait. We're turning this into a relationship, but if you really care for someone, you're really finding chemistry and attraction with them, then make the effort and worst case scenario, you know, they don't want it back.
Right, right. I mean, just going off of what you said, if you want to maintain a relationship, right, and things have been going good, like strike while the iron is hot. Like when you're in that kind of post-coital, like golden glow, it's like, hey, I'd still like to see you. Like we can do FaceTime, Skype. Like there's so much technology. There's like too much technology for me at this point to keep track of. But I think it's very important, like you're saying. Manage expectations, set up the expectations. And I think one thing that is important is, I mean, you correct me if I'm wrong, I would say like if you can, you know, do some sort of visual FaceTime, whatever component like Skype, like maybe once a week, I think is a good sort of like rule of thumb. What do you think about that?
I think that's great. I think you have to feel it out because some people are really hate phone conversations, for example. I have a couple of good friends, girlfriends that hate phone calls, right? So you can try it out and ask them, say, so can I call you at this time? And call them. And then while you're on the phone with them, say, you know, I'd love to see you. Like visually, can we talk now on FaceTime or Skype, like you said? Or next time, it would be great to see you. Can I call you on that next time? And just also, I think at the beginning, it's just important to, just like when you're dating in any situation, to just feel it out and not put too much pressure, but like show that you want it. Because that desire is really important, that other person feels it.
That they are desired and that they want to continue this, right? Because it's, you know, a two-way street. Yeah. Okay. And another suggestion I would give is having, you know, presumably things are progressing and you're maintaining the relationship, have like kind of mini date ideas to go on. You know, you can just like FaceTime while you're walking around Hollywood Boulevard, like, oh, you know, here's this kind of interesting like hobo or clown or whatever is going
sharing
on.
Sharing your life.
Yeah, sharing your life.
That's a great idea.
Right. So another question that we get a lot is, okay, now I'm dating somebody, things are good, and we're in like 3 months in, but you know, you start to maybe get to know them a little bit too well, right? Maybe this, I don't want to say the spark, but the mystery is going out of the relationship because you know each other's schedule. Mm-hmm. Like, how do you keep that spark going when you like almost maybe like living together?
So we're talking about 3 month mark or like living together mark?
I mean, just
that's different to me.
Well, right, but just the feeling of like the newness has started to go away. Like that honeymoon period has, you know, you're past that, right? And now you're settling down, but how do you maintain the spark,
yeah.
Right?
So I think that a lot of times that people start to feel that they're separating or there's disconnect between them, which is synonymous with the spark going, I'm just using different terms that different people use, is that you often didn't spend the time at the beginning learning about the things about them that matter. Like their values and yours and your vision, and especially at that time before you jump into the moving in and even more serious next level of the commitment, is having those conversations in a light way. It doesn't have to come up. You know, you can talk about your friends that are this, and how do you feel about that? They're having kids. Is that something you're into? You know, maybe you're talking about that earlier, but I think that spark comes from intimacy, and intimacy comes from getting to know one another on a deeper and deeper level all the time. And when you're always getting to know one another, you're never going to run out of things to learn. So if you keep putting your detective hat and staying curious about the other person, the spark doesn't need to go away. So before we get into like the which we can, and I will, about the spark going away specifically, things, actions you can do, I would remind yourself and stay mindful of the mindset of it.
Right.
So that's the first part.
Okay. No, that is excellent advice. One of the things I tell my guys is the easiest way to know if with a girl that you're with that the difference between maybe like a one night stand or a serious girlfriend is the ability for you as a man to like open up and reveal like your vulnerability, and you can there's strength and vulnerability, and there's like the woman when you tell her these things about you that maybe you were scared of saying to other people, you know, not only does she feel special, but like you can get that off your shoulders and you can share, you know, of yourself instead of like trying to hide behind like the machismo, the bravado.
Yeah.
But you're saying there are some tips, like specific actions.
Absolutely.
What can they do?
Absolutely. I've got a great strategy. It's called the Fantastic Five.
And so you are Fantastic Five. All right.
It's not my strategy. It's my teacher's strategy.
Okay.
Patia. But it's amazing. And it just is a good way to remember it with what it's called. So, the biggest tip about keeping the spark alive, big picture, is do what you did at the beginning, right?
Okay.
That stuff never needs to stop. It should not end. The contacting in the middle of the day, the sending a picture, the FaceTiming to show the hobo or the... That's not a good example. But, you know, like the beautiful, the butterfly garden that you pass, I don't know, or the beach, to sending a photo of the sunset. Like, I live in Tel Aviv, so you go to the beach a lot, the sunset's like, oh, here you go, babe. Is remembering that. So remembering to go back to what was at the beginning, and the things that you did at the beginning are as follows, put in categories. You've got being polite, remembering to be polite. Please, thank you, appreciating, being grateful for the little things that your woman or man does in your life.
Not taking them for granted.
Not taking them for granted,
yeah.
And showing it with those words of being polite and holding doors, and I don't mean just chivalry, both ways. If she was also that way, if you're very, you know, old fashioned, then continue doing that. Don't stop. That's what she's used to. She likes that about you. Why would you stop that now?
Mm-hmm.
Another one is the greeting. How you greet them. Are you just hi? Are you getting up to see them? Are you getting excited? Are they of you? And if they're also being less excited about you, you need to go ahead because you're watching this video and you need to start doing it. And you need to remember how they like to be greeted, or ask them, how do you want? Do you want me to get up? Do you want me to? Do you want to come to me? Do you want me to hug you and grab your ass? Do you want?
Okay. Sorry. That would be awesome.
But some women, I have clients who want their partner. They're married, they have children, to grab them in some
they
way.
They want them to public display
in,
of it.
Yes, it's in their home. It's so great. It's wonderful. Sex is a huge part. Intimacy is a huge part of what changes a best friendship from right? From an intimate relationship. But you need to have that conversation with your partner or this girlfriend that's becoming a partner and find out what it is if you don't already know. So that's the greeting. Then we've got the kiss. Especially if it's just the beginning and it's not years where you like are living as roommates, which I work with couples all through their whole like lifetime of their relationship, is the kiss. Making sure that every day you're having a really special, intimate kiss that does not necessarily lead to sex, which it can, but that's not the point.
It's more intimate kiss, not a sexual kiss.
Which, for some people, that's hard. For my partner, when we started talking about that and doing that, he was like, the hard part is that when I kiss you like that, I want to make love. And I'm like, okay, but we can work around it, right? Because sometimes we can, and sometimes at that time, we're not able to. You have to go to work now, right? But that's also something you can talk about. And after a period of time, can also find out that later in a relationship, even 6 months, a year, the way you like to be kissed or the way your partner likes to be kissed changes.
No.
So having a conversation about that is really interesting.
Oh, is that you're like checking in?
Yeah. Because we can't just assume things all the time, right? We need to ask questions. And some people, even though your partner may be super assertive and direct, there may be times when they're afraid. And you opening that up and you being vulnerable, as well as asking the questions and opening up the conversation for her or his vulnerability, that just makes them feel safe.
Okay.
That's almost all of them. Then we've got the words. Using kind words that you used in the beginning. Certain things you wouldn't say before, don't say them now. If your partner or your girlfriend or, you know, long-term girlfriend likes that you're really kind, then don't start cursing all the time.
Yeah, don't be crass.
Don't be crass if that's not what they know of you. Like, and if that wasn't real, then you need to tell them, by the way, I was full of shit.
Just presenting his best front.
Yeah, I curse all the time. Are you?
So that was like really good stuff, all right? Amazing tips, things that I sort of knew, but I had never conceptualized. So I'm really loving it, and I hope you guys do too. Now, before I let you go, what is one last nugget of wisdom that you can give our audience about anything about a relationship? Maintaining it, keeping the spark, you know, making it really exciting, you know, what's your relationship tip that you can give our audience?
So I'm going to sound exciting, but it will lead to excitement. Be aware of your commitment to yourself.
Okay.
What are you committed to? What were you committed to before when you were feeling really good, like when you were doing your boot camp and things like that? What were you doing that was making you feel the best about yourself that you could feel? Don't stop those things either. Just like we said a few minutes ago, don't stop the things you did at the beginning. Don't stop those things. Whatever exercise regimen, whatever eating, whatever hanging out with your friends, whatever being in nature, whatever it was, making sure you get a weekend away, sports you play, whatever it is. Don't stop that stuff, because that's what keeps you the best version of you, that keeps you connected to yourself. And the type of man, especially if I'm talking, you know, to your audience, to the type of men or man that a woman wants, he's connected to himself. And only that type of man can be vulnerable. Only that type of man can hold space for an emotional, in a good way, emotional, femininely strong woman. So remember that, and then also make sure that you're showing her that with example, and then you're letting her have that space, and you're encouraging her to be in her own element, in her own life. And that way, when you two are together, you really are the happiest versions of yourself, and then you have the best relationship. My last nugget, it goes with this, is you. I believe, and I find this really helps empower my clients, is there are three elements in your relationship. There's you, there's your partner, and your relationship. And your relationship is its own being.
It's its own organism.
It's totally its own living being. So treat it as such, and it will work.
Okay, no, I love that, because a lot of times I'll hear from my clients, like, you know, they're in a relationship, they're like, thank you so much, and then all of a sudden they break up, and it's like, oh, it's because I just stopped hanging out with my friends, or I just became obsessed. It was all about her, and I stopped socializing and enjoying myself, and that feeling, you know, it kind of is a lot, like you're saying a little bit earlier, pressure on that person. So I really love that. Okay, guys, that was awesome advice. Are you taking notes? You should be taking notes. All right, Jamie. Tell our audience, how can they find more about you?
Awesome. So you can go to my website, jamiefaycoaching.com. Yep.
We'll put it here.
Right there. And you can get actually my free Transform Your Relationship 5-Day Challenge, which is an awesome resource. It's a huge, comprehensive, not huge, but amazing workbook and video series. So you can actually use it to get a little bit of...
It's free.
Yeah, it's free.
Just go to her website and get it for free, guys.
Totally free. And get on my mailing list. And the other thing is you can check out my website and check out my Relationship Mastermind, which is a group coaching program. Mm-hmm. You can write to me if you have any questions about that. And you can join my brand new Facebook group, which is Millennial Love, Dating, and Relationships.
Nice. Thank you so much, Jamie. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed that. We have more material, more YouTube videos that you guys can check out. Okay? Be sure to subscribe. And bye, guys.
Bye.
Thanks for watching our video. I hope you liked it. And make sure you guys subscribe to this channel and watch all our other videos. Great news, too. Every Monday, we'll be putting out a new weekly video. That's right, we've got educational seminars, street interviews, fun infield pickup videos, and anything else we can come up with that's fun for you guys to watch. So check back.